I want to thank you one more time for joining us this program. My name is Emeni Kerewu, and we have an in-house guest, our daily guest, who is always in this show and who is a great mind indeed. His name is Kelechi Imo. Kelechi, you're welcome.
Good morning.
Our first port of call this morning is Inner Galaxy Group. For the past 2 weeks, they've been on the media for negative reasons, and there have been so many kind of allegations against the organization, spanning from dehumanization of workers to overworking workers to molestation. So many kind of allegations, but we took our time on yesterday to visit the organization. We visited the Inner Galaxy Group to exactly know what are the issues, so that we can actually talk to people who are working there directly and know what are the issues. The Inner Galaxy Group is located in Ukwa East. That is in Abia State, almost very close to Port Harcourt, and a lot of people are working there. We gathered yesterday that they have close to 1,000 workforce. That's a big number, you know, and a good chunk of it is from the locals. Don't you think it's something that we've been talking about creating of job for people and stuff? That is another big job creation. What do you think about that?
Yes, considering the relationship between China and Nigeria, I don't expect anything less. China establishing a company of such a magnitude in here in Abia shows that there is also this relationship between the state government and the Chinese government. However, it's not just about employing a huge workforce. That's quite huge, yes. But then, what about their welfare? Are they just working for working sake, or are they kept comfortable? Are they actually getting the commensurate efforts they have been putting in? Because the complaint we've gathered so far is that they are not being treated well. The comfort of the workers is also should be looked into.
Yes, as somebody who had a first-hand interaction with the management and also moved around the company to see what's happening in the company, I personally discovered that most of the allegations which are made against the company may not be completely true. The point is that we agree in totality that, of course, they are a Chinese company and they are here to work and make profit. So most of most companies, most companies like don't have weekends, because once you own your massive engines, it has to keep running.
Yes.
So there is no Sunday, there is no Saturday. Yeah. So those things does not exist.
They do more of shifts.
So yeah. That's what you see there. And then one of the things we discover, one of the allegations, of course, you can see a picture already of me and the one of the Chinese top heads there, and their lawyer Brandstan Namdi, who was there when we took a picture as regards our visit yesterday. But you discover that there was this particular allegations of them putting people in bad living squalors. We discovered that particular narrative was not actually the way it is, because from the beginning, people were not actually, workers are not expected to live there, except expatriates, which provisions were made for.
Okay.
So other workers were not expected to live there. They walk and go back home and come the next day. But you know, the COVID-19 is setting,
yeah,
and there was a need to make sure that people don't go out and come back with disease. So they had to give options. Do you want to stay in the company and stay with us or work? Or you want to
that
go
period
home,
of time.
Or that period of time?
Mm-hmm.
Or you want to go home? If you go home, we will not allow you to come back, but we'll be giving you half salary. That was
even benefit.
That's what they are
from a private
from the private company, that they will give you half salary. And based on what we get, they're paying around their minimum wage. They're paying around minimum, we're above 30,000 to normal labor workers. So they say, if you are going to stay home, we're going to pay you half salary. But if you are going to stay inside the company throughout this period, we'll give you extra bonuses. And there were some emergency provision of where to sleep. It was not as if ab initio that people were sleeping there. There was no plan of people sleeping there. There was this hush to put up a place. And they made a provision of this container cabins where people can hush. But when we get there, we find that they're already building permanent structures, houses for workers and stuff. The videos, as you can see, houses that have been built by the organization to now house to make workers more comfortable. So I think that some of these allegations were not completely the way it is, you know. And there are allegations also that there seems to be an attack from a sister company who feel those kind of allegations. So before we, the lot of things yesterday we discovered, which disproved some of the allegations we had ab initio. But obviously the company is a very big one.
Wow.
A very, very big one.
Wow. First, I know that this period, a lot of companies used a lot of desperate measures. In fact, if your narrative is true, which I believe, the staff should be grateful that they were not laid off. Because a lot of companies laid off staff. They didn't even pay them. A lot of companies did that in Lagos. They were not even paid. They were saying, we cannot pay you. Go. But this one, they gave you option of either staying back and staying with us. If you must go home, we'll pay you half salary. So those of them who stayed back should have been ready.
And obviously, again, I believe that nobody would have expected the company to build those lodges within few seconds.
Is it magic?
And you know that this thing about COVID-19 came as a shock.
Everybody
was by surprise. We visited the canteen. We also visited the hospital.
They have a hospital.
Yeah, they have a clinic inside.
Wow.
You can see the video here.
Wow.
That's the clinic. That. These are doctors. These are even people who are inside the clinic.
But you know one funny thing? I never knew such a company existed.
I'm telling you, wow. This is steel area. These are all condemned materials which they combine. So now rod, they're now making to this and building iron rods.
Wow.
5, 10, 12 mm, 24 mm,
wow.
They now convert it. You can see expatriates too who are working at that particular, you see the big mm. In fact, if you even see the facility, it has stayed there for some while.
What kind of business does Intergalactic do?
Okay. Goodness, Wilson, I work with the public relations department. Inner Galaxy, as you said, is a group of company. In Inner Galaxy group of company, we have Inner Galaxy Steel Company, as you said. We have the Starwich Recycling Technology Company, and we have Josin. What Inner Galaxy Steel Company does is that they make use of scrap. We work with scrap. And then they convert this scrap, they recycle this scrap to produce steel rod. For Josin, which is also incorporated in Inner Galaxy group, they are into fabrication of truss. We get truss and then they fabricate it and produce truss. And then for Starwich Recycling Technology, they're into recycling of plastics. They recycle plastic PET bottles, all those fallow bottles you see along the road. They pick them up, they recycle them, and they produce polyester fibers. Inner Galaxy Group is more like, is a company that converts more of waste to money.
Can you tell us a little bit the role Inner Galaxy has played in the community concerning how they convert waste? Because obviously we used to have large dumps of waste. Mm. What has been the effect of this in our community?
Talking of waste management, as you know, scraps, they cannot be easily degraded. It's a multinational company into making sure that these scraps are removed. Because they are very dangerous. When you look at the safety aspect, when they are just there, they can be used as weapons. So they pick up these scraps and they convert it to steel rods. And when you look at the community too, like the human resource manager said, we've been staying peacefully with the community. Since Inner Galaxy came, it has been a source of development to the community in the area of employment and in the area of development.
Obviously, we have come to discover that apart from this bad press at the moment, we have a lot of benefit of Inner Galaxy, the steel company. At least the removal of this bunch of waste from our communities is helping us a lot. Have there been any incidents where a staff complained of being maltreated or being he felt that he's not well treated?
In that area, we have an anti-harassment policy. And once any staff feels being molested or harassed in any area, the first call point is to make sure you write to the direct supervisor. And once you feel that the direct supervisor cannot actually handle it, you can actually come to the office and make your report. We have stationed boxes, information boxes, and suggestion boxes, you know, all around the company. If you feel that maybe you want to protect yourself or your confidentiality, you can actually drop a written note over in that box. Then we go there, bring it out, and we take action.
Of course, I am Emenike Rebu, the anchor of this particular interaction today, and we are rounding up our interaction with the Inner Galaxy Steel company, some of their staffs. We've talked about various issues that trend on the social media as regards maltreatment, dehumanization of workers, and what we are seeing on ground does not actually depict what the informations we got on via Twitter.